All right, so here's a video that should have happened a long time ago. Today we're going to talk about ultra power supplies. Stay tuned. So check it out. We're going to look at the Ultra LS and the LSP series of PSUs. These things have been out forever, and no one's ever done a video of them. I don't know why, but I never got around to it, I guess, or I never even thought of the need for video. These things are huge sellers. People buy these like by the metric ton. It's ridiculous how many of these go out there on the market, how much they sell, and they're just a great affordable option. Now, what happens with these Ultra PSUs is that they're not like the super pinnacle of PSUs, but they are very, very good. They're high quality, and they have a lifetime warranty, which is the best part about them. Pretty much you can see here, I don't know if they have the stickers on them, but yeah, if you see this one right here, lifetime warranty, okay? That means that if you register this product on their website, sign up your name, tell them that, you know, your basic information, and once your product is registered, you actually get a full lifetime warranty. They'll even cross ship to you. So if your PSU goes bad, they'll ship you a new one, you ship them the old one, you pay for it or whatever, then they'll give you back the money. I'm not sure how it works, but either way, they're going to cross ship to you, which is great. It means your downtime is minimized in case anything does go wrong. Now, there's two basic series you have to know about here. I'm going to go over, actually three in total, but I'm going to show two today. First of all, the LS series over here. This is your basic power supply. It doesn't come with much in the box. The cables aren't sleeved. It's definitely not modular. It's very, very basic. But here's what it does. It gets the job done, and it's very affordable, okay? It's got just enough amperage to do everything you need. If you look here on the side, it's 18 amps on this power supply, and it's only a 350-watt power supply. That means that even if you're running a very small system with a small processor, you can actually still run a decent graphics card on one of these PSUs in a very affordable system. This is exactly what you want to run with. Now, this LS series comes with 350, 400, 500, and then 600-watt PSUs. Now, generally speaking, if you're going to be running a higher-end system with a bigger video card and a bigger processor, you're going to overclock a little bit. You don't want to try to run a 600 watt of these or a 500 watt. You actually want to come over here to the LSP series. They're going to give you a little bit cleaner power, and that's going to make a go a long way as far as overclocking goes. And as for gaming, they're also going to have more voltage on the 12 volt rail. Now, it's also important to know that these are all single rail designs. That's actually a really good thing. Their design is very efficient at producing a lot of amperage out through one plug to a graphics card. It's going to suck up a lot of power. Now, it's good to know, though, also as well, all the connections that these all have, and I'll show them to you while we're here. Now, this is the LS 350 watt. All right, so as you can imagine, you're going to get a 24-pin motherboard connector. This has actually got a 4-pin breakaway, so it's 24, but you can remove this 4 at the end and have 20 to fit your older motherboards. You also have two of these SATA connectors, so you can include up to two hard drives, four Molex connectors, those are right there, and then you also have these fan headers. And then finally, you have one PCI Express 6-pin connector for your graphics cards. So again, very basic setup. It's going to let you get a motherboard, a CPU, you know, your GPU, and that's the basic functionality. Two hard drives, and then whatever four Molexes you can, and a couple fans. That's what you're going to get here. You're going to get a bare metal finish, 120 millimeter fan. It's going to keep everything cool. It's going to work great, no problem. Now, when you move into the LSP series, obviously you're going to tell it's a big difference. It's all matte black finish instead of metal, which is really nice. Everything is sleeved very nice. I'm not sure if they do it by hand or by machine, but they do a really good job, especially at the ends where they have the rubber the heat wrap that you put on there with a heat gun. They do a really good job on all that stuff, so it is all matted. It's also a 135 millimeter fan instead of a 120, so you're actually getting better cooling. It's going to spin quieter, yet it's going to give you more airflow, so it's going to go at a slower RPM. It's going to increase the efficiency because it's going to drop the temps inside the PSU, and it's also going to be quieter. And then also, as far as connectivity goes, you're going to get a lot more. So, mind you, this is a 550 watt. These are all color-coded, by the way. So here's the 550. Okay, here's the 450, the 650, and the 750 in the back. They are color-coded, and these you are going to get, again, a little bit more connectivity. So you're going to get the 24-pin motherboard connector with the 4-pin breakaway. That's pretty much going to make it a 20. You're going to get, as far as Molexes goes, you're going to get four of these. These are the 4-pin Molexes. Now, SATA is where you get the real upgrade. You go from two to having four of these, so you get a lot more SATA connectors, and that's useful. You also get, where are you? Here we go. Here's your P4. You're going to get one of those, obviously. You don't need more than one. And then on top of that, PCI Express, the 6-pin, you're going to get two of them. That means that you can either run a fatter graphics card that needs two of these, or you can run SLI on a very simple older cards. But to be honest with you, I recommend running a big card with two of these. So you do get a little bit more, and of course you can go to a higher wattage. You can go all the way up to 750 watts with this series. You're not stuck at 600 watts with the LS series, but that gives you the basic idea of what's going on with these power supplies. So simple gaming rigs, you know, basic workstation, stuff like that, home, office, gaming, work-related stuff. And then on top of that, there's, of course, the X3 series, which is the Enthusiast's modular SLI Crossfire. And from what I understand, very soon, I don't know if it's a secret or not, but there is going to be a ultra high-end X4 series from Ultra. They're going to try to break into the space of some of the other big-name brands by producing a power supplies that are just, like, over the top, you know, efficiency certified, active PFC, you know, like big fans, big wattage numbers, big amperage numbers, single rail systems, good, good stuff with lifetime warranty as always. So stay tuned for those. And again, very affordable, useful systems from Ultra to the LS and the LSP series of PSUs. If you have any questions on them, feel free to email me and I'll see you guys next time. For more information on these Ultra LS and LSP power supplies, type in Ultra Power Supplies into the search engine of any of these major retailers. For Computer TV, I'm Albert. We'll be right back.